teachers. That's right. Every month, right here at Zebra Zone, we talk about a new big idea character trait.
And a big idea is just something that grows inside of you and then can help you change the world all around you.
I'm so excited about this month's big idea. Let's go ahead and reveal it, okay?
Excellent. Are you all ready?
Yeah!
Okay. Okay. I want you to say it really nice and sweetly and loudly when we reveal it. Okay, on the count of one, two,
this month.
Oh,
can anyone tell me why?
Oh, it's because we've started to
No.
Exactly.
No.
Yeah.
What is this?
Holiday decorations. Do you like them?
No, this is incomplete. It's not working for me.
No.
What? If this is your first time here at Zebra Zone, boys and girls, I have to tell you, this happens all the time. I apologize. Sometimes Mrs. Smith just gets a little,
Oh, this is it! I have found it! This will complete it! Yes! Now our holiday decorating is complete!
What is that?
What do you mean?
What is that?
Are you serious? You don't know what this is? What is it, everybody? Yes, it's a T-Rex. It's a dinosaur, but who is it? A reindeer dinosaur. Now that's just silly. No, this is Gustav, the Christmas dinosaur. Don't you know him? Generation coming to. You don't know who saw the Christmas dinosaur? Oh, now they do. Well, I would like to take this opportunity to instruct the future generation about Gustav. I have a special song. Would you like to hear my song?
I really don't think that's necessary.
Oh, yes. The Christmas dinosaur had a pair of tiny arms. He couldn't put up ornaments or place atop a tree a star. But in his walnut-sized brain, he came up with a great new plan. He'd ask the
Zero. Listen.
There we go. Here's Gustav's plan. He told a pterodactyl the right time to drop a star on the tray. That's how he found his joy and put away his T-Rex rage. Gustav, the holiday dinosaur, lived in the Mesozoic age.
Just great.
Yeah,
thank you for sharing. I really don't think I have anything to add to that.
I mean, what could you add to that?
Why don't we go on to our next video?
Would you like to hear about the Triceratops?
You have another one?
Up on the Triceratops there was.
Great.
Thank you.
guys here just for one second, real quick, if I can have your attention. Hi, everybody. Recently, a lot of you, and there was a very large number of you, were involved in a fundraiser that we did, and it was for our PTO. And for those of you that don't really know what our PTO is, your parents might be involved in it. It's our parent-teacher organization. And it's a group of parents and teachers that get together and they organize ways to raise money for our school. And what they do is they give that money to the school to buy things for you guys. So it's a really good organization. It is very helpful to you and to your teachers. It helps provide teachers with some of the materials that you guys get to use every day. And I know you don't want to hear any more about what PTO is. You want to know why I'm up here with this hat on and what these little envelopes are. Well, of all the people that sold stuff for our PTO, we had five people that were the top sellers in the school. And what I would like to do is I would like to present to them a little gift from the PTO for doing such a fantastic job. So when I call your name, come on up. If you can't get up here, we can try to help you up. I'd like to get you up here on stage and we'll get started. So our number five seller was Ava Helt.
Ava.
Ava, can you hop up here? I bet she can get up. There we go. All right, good job. Hey, Ava, this is a gift for you. That is $10 from our PTO. Congratulations. Way to go. Our fourth place winner, our fourth place top seller, Amberly Craigbaum. If you could come on up. Amberly will be winning a $20 gift for fourth place, and congratulations to her. We'll make sure that she gets it. Sophia Clapper, number three, come on up. There is a $30 gift certificate for you. I hope you enjoy it. Congratulations. Now, we had two top sellers, and the number two seller of the school was Brayson Flory. Come on up. You are our first place seller for the entire school. How does that feel?
Good.
Awesome. I'm very proud of you. And I have got a $50 gift certificate for you. And the fundraising organization also gave you a... Is it a Kindle Fire? Is that what you got? Wow. How have you gotten it yet? Is it cool? So she also won a Kindle Fire from the organization that we did our fundraiser through. I want to give a big round of applause to everybody. And I want to thank everyone, not just the four up here, but everybody that participated and that helped. Big thanks to the parents and the staff that were also helped out with that, and obviously to our PTO for organizing that. Very well done.
Here we go.
chest on top. It was so good. Of course there was too much, so we didn't finish it. I saved the best piece for later. I didn't think about it yesterday. I guess I was too busy with school. But today, the craving hit. So when I went to get the piece of cake, the one I'd been thinking about all day, it was gone. And I knew exactly who to blame. I was pretty steamed. I mean, it was my cake. It was my birthday. It wasn't fair. And I was gonna let him have it. I thought about it. Even though I was mad, I knew he's gonna be my brother for the rest of my life. One day, I figured I'd probably have worse things to be mad about, so this time, I let it slide. Maybe being 9 does feel a little different after all.
$20 and I typed in $250. No, I don't have any money to buy him the Hadron Collider. Oh,
maybe you can get a refund.
No, look, right up here on the corner of the screen. It will take 90 days for a refund just for creating tension for a comedic skit.
Well, that's very specific.
I don't know what I'm gonna do. Christmas is ruined.
What now, Gloria? I know you're upset, but Christmas isn't ruined. Christmas is about more than presents. Dad and I always taught you that. Yeah, maybe Marshall will surprise you. Maybe he won't be upset.
Mom, you're brilliant! I'll just run away and hide!
Wait, is that... That's not... I don't know what I... Gloria, wait! Gloria!
And I just heard this awesome story from my cousin's friend, Chip. Chip's cool, but let's talk about his dad for a second. I mean, Chip, really? Why didn't he just name his kid, like, Gringle or Naruto or something? Anyhow, Chip and his little brother, Kevin, were totally stoked last Christmas because they were finally going to Wally World for, like, a whole week. They'd been begging their dad for 3 years to go. And they've been doing some crazy stuff to earn money, like dog portraits and professional breakdancing. But then, a few days before they're supposed to leave for their trip, Dad walks in and he says, "Guys, I'm sorry, but we're gonna have to cancel the trip. Dad's got a crazy emergency at work, and his boss is making him stay for the whole week." Chip and Kevin cannot believe their ears. At first, Chip is like, "I'm gonna hack your boss's computer." But then he sees how upset Kevin is, and he realizes he's gotta pull it together for him. So he says, "You know what? Who needs Wally World? We are gonna make Chip World." And Kevin's like, "So is that like making a fort out of Pringles or something?" Chip has a plan. He says, "We are gonna do stuff that is gonna blow your socks off." Chip puts together the coolest stuff ever to do while their dad's away at work. They host a life-size board game tournament, and they play flashlight tag throughout the house. And Kevin wins because he's like, "I'm the flashlight king." And they write and shoot their own scary movie. And they hold a red carpet movie premiere for their dad when he finally gets home from work. So they were pretty bummed about missing the trip. But it turns out to be a really great Christmas vacation after all. So kids, I hope this story helps you remember that joy is finding a way to be happy even when things don't go your way. Like being named Chip. I can sure crunch to that. See you guys next time.
Man, who knew that girl could run that fast?
Ooh. I don't know.
Mom! Ah! Stranger danger! Stranger danger!
No, it's me!
But Laura?
Yes!
You've got hair on your lip.
It's fake. It's a disguise.
Why?
I can't bear to see Marshall's face on Christmas Day when he finds out I didn't get him anything. So instead, I dressed up like Uncle Nettie from West Virginia.
Well, I reckon you do look quite a lot like good old Nettie, but I don't think Marshall will fall for it.
Well, hey there, Grandma. Has any rich philanthropist come by and drop something off for me?
Huh? Oh, no, podiatrist. Just... Well,
your mom had to leave for a few weeks. Yeah, she called me up to come take care of you.
Oh, well, that's kind of sudden. But you made great time getting here. Thank you for that. Remember when they happened last time? Last time we got to do something like this, it was when Mom broke my favorite chemistry set and didn't have any idea how to tell me. Remember that?
Yeah.
That was horrible. Absolutely terrible. But that's okay. I think I know why she left so quickly.
You do?
Yep. She went to get me the Hadron Collider.
Oh. Sure.
You see, I can tell because she's been acting funny. Whenever I bring up what I want for Christmas, she does all this hemming and hawing and say things like, "It's so expensive, we can't afford it, don't be disappointed." She is terrible at reverse psychology.
Well, what if you're wrong? I don't know, what if she really didn't get you anything?
That's a good one. Oh, I love your sense of humor, Uncle Ned, and that's a good one.
but you know, Marshall, I love Uncle Ned's sense of humor too, but what he kind of has a point. What if something happened and your mom couldn't get you anything for Christmas? How would you feel?
Nothing?
Yeah. Yeah. How would you feel?
Well, if I were to tell you I wouldn't be disappointed, that'd be a lie. But you know, Mom has always been real good about telling us what Christmas is really about. She says it's not about the presents, and it's not about the food, and it's not even about family, relatives we get to see every once in a while. She always said Christmas is about being thankful. Thankful for all of our blessings, thankful for that baby born a long time ago. So, yeah, I'd probably be disappointed, but it's okay, it'd still be Christmas. I'd be happy, we'd still have family, we'd still have house, we'd still have food on the table. Are you okay? Well, that's okay. Well, it'll still be Christmas. Even though it didn't go exactly like I wanted to, I can still be happy. It's Christmas. That's the most important thing.
Oh, I love you, kiddo.
Oh, and I love you, too.
You know what, Marshall? How about when I get the money back from the bill I overpaid, I give you that Hadron Collider deal?
Deal? We better go get you a tissue.
Yeah, I need one too.
Oh, Mom, could you do me a favor?
Yeah.
When you go to pay for my Hadron Collider, don't try to be so young. Just write a check.
All right, sweetie.
Talk about being jolly. I have some more information on box tops for you. Last, we did a contest for October and November because we only had partial months for those. And just to let everybody know, Mrs. Bollinger's class won the turkey cookie party. They brought in over 700 box tops during that time. That's pretty awesome. For the month of December, and we already have a few box tops turned in for this month. But Santa has made a deal with me. You about Preston, you're not quite there, but if we can get 2,000 box tops the rest of this month, Singing Santa will come and visit Columbia School. So start looking, go to your pantries, guys. Go to the pantry, look through your boxes, find those box tops. Don't clip anything unless your mom says it's okay, but bring them in, start collecting them, because we sure want Singing Santa to come and visit us. And oh, by the way, should we get more than 2,000?
Thank you.